So hello everybody and teacher. We are makeup group and today we will present and introduce about makeup. Our group has three people, Yuan, me and Sunai. So the first thing that I'm going to tell you, what is makeup? So the second one is the benefit of makeup and disadvantage of makeup. So makeup is the cosmetic such as lipstick or powder applied to the face but used to enhance or tighten the appearance. So makeup can help someone look younger than her real age, despite the reminder that will make skin age faster, that means anti-aging. And second one is that makeup is the role that hides certain flaws that you don't want to be seen by others, that are corner up. And last one, transform with makeup, you can stop dreaming. Although makeup will not make you look exactly like them, you can definitely guarantee that a resemblance can capture the essence of what they may help accomplish.
And I think makeup does enhance confidence. In my opinion, wearing makeup helped me feel more beautiful, therefore making me more confident about myself. There are many groups that conducted a research or study that state that makeup truly gives a woman confidence.
Yes, absolutely. I guess I think wearing makeup boosts confidence level. It makes us look good, and if we look good, we feel good. Usually, girls which are not pretty have so much less confidence. They don't want to go outside of their room or being exposed in public because of their looks. However, if they groom themselves, they can have confidence in themselves and they can become more and more social. I have fun with that having studies show that women with makeup are rated as more attractive, as better eyes. That might actually be because they are sleep more happy.
So let's tell you about makeup. So makeup, it can be a way of owning your face. People who wear a full face of makeup every single day by choice and not because of social pressure are doing exactly what they desire when it comes to their looks, and completely owning the way you present yourself to the world in a way that feels right to you is nothing short of only positive.
Makeup can be an artistic expression of yourself. Someone who wears a full face of makeup most days might be more into the creative side of the cosmetics rather than the beauty one. Of course, anyone who wears a full face of makeup regularly is bound to be into beauty, but some folks utilize makeup to unleash their inner artist.
Wearing eye-catching makeup might suggest you're comfortable in your own skin. People who are unafraid of wearing bright or eye-catching makeup of any kind and likely comfortable in the skin they are in. Otherwise, they probably wouldn't want to draw the attention to their appearance. The individuals are lacking self-confidence. And the fact that there's no shame in being proud of your body and the way to present it, which is an amazing thing.
And the next thing is you can draw attention to what makes you unique. Perhaps you're someone who has tons of freckles, a pot, wine stain, or really puffed lips. Everyone has something that makes them unique, and makeup can help you highlight this area or errors. to draw your attention to your individuality. Being confident about that what makes you you is a brilliant body positive skill.
It can raise awareness of different gender identities. So when someone who is not a female or a feminine person, like a cis man or a gender person, perhaps, wears makeup, it has the potential to shatter tattoos and make a heart-beating body positive statement. In the past, makeup has often been associated with women, but other people are starting to use it to open the word eyes to a gender spectrum that is less binaristic and less art. Makeup can be used to celebrate our gender identities and make others more aware of the many ways we are also to have a body. Plus, it sends a very general message that people should not be put in boxes.
And it can help change people's perception of beauty. The world is changing for the better, and I personally feel grateful to have been born in this era. The advances in technology are incredible. The current spotlight of feminism has been long awaited, and the amazing advance in medicine are just a few of great things. But one of the most brilliant things I have discovered in recent years is body positivity and recognizing that everybody is beautiful, in addition to the realization that we no longer need to measure up to the beauty ideals that the media and society have set for us. By wearing makeup that challenges beauty norms, such as brightly colored eyebrows or unconventional lipstick color, we all gradually help change the world's perception of trans beauty.
And now we will watch a video about Is Makeup Bad for You, Lady?
Driven by sexual selection, we often attempt to accentuate our features with makeup. So what exactly is in makeup products, and should we trust these substances that we apply to our bodies? Could makeup actually be bad for you? Historically, ancient Egyptians would grind up a mineral substance containing primarily lead sulfide to around their eyes, creating the sultry Cleopatra look. Little did they know that lead is a potent neurotoxin, which can lead to learning and behavioral difficulties in children and decrease fertility in both men and women. Later in 1891, creams, lotions, and blush containing compounds of the radioactive element radium were also sold to women in Europe, promising a youthful glow. Until the harmful effects of exposure to radioactivity was discovered, that is. But makeup has come a long way, and now there are only trace amounts of lead found in our products. Lead is found in nature and is therefore an unintentional contaminant from the manufacturing process. An FDA study of 400 tubes of lipstick found concentrations ranging from 0.026 parts per million to 7.19 parts per million of lead, which is under Health Canada's limits of 10 parts per million. Lipstick is about 47% oils, 36% pigments, 17% waxes, and 5% other components, including preservatives. The oils are primarily castor oils, extracted from a bean which contains the protein ricin, one of the most toxic substances on this planet, which has been used as a biological weapon. However, the process of extracting castor oil involves heating, thereby denaturing ricin and rendering it inactive. Pigments now use synthetic dyes due to cost and production efficiencies, although traditionally red pigments were extracted from dried and crushed cochineal insects. Some blue pigments are created with ferrocyanide. Cyanide is extremely deadly. However, in this compound structure, cyanide has a very strong bond to iron. A As a result, it is unable to come apart to poison us by eyeshadow. When it comes to mascara, we recommend tossing the tube after 3 months of opening. Harmful bacteria of the Streptococcus species and certain fungi were discovered thriving in 36.4% of mascara tubes. And this is especially important for contact lens wearers, as bacteria can easily enter the microabrasions caused by the lens itself. Parabens have been a big concern as well, as they're in a myriad of cosmetic products. Paraben works by mimicking estrogen and binding to estrogen receptors. This can cause the expression of genes to be changed and communication within cells to be altered. Additionally, it can lead to the growth of certain breast cancer cells. However, many products are switching to paraben-free, and a lot of research still needs to be done in order to reach any definitive conclusions. We made a YouTube makeup tutorial parody on ASAP Thought to show the science behind the chemicals being used in common makeup products, neurotoxin.
Everything in this world has some pros and cons. That's how you build products. As you know that the cosmetic and makeup are utilized by a person to attain beautiful, elegant, and stylish look, but if you are using these ingredients, then you should have a picture knowledge about the dark side of the world.